Hey everybody, it's The Move. I'm Greg. This is Joe.
What's up?
Today we'll be reacting to DJ Khalid, This Is My Year, featuring Diddy, Rick Ross, Big Sean, and A Boogie with the Hoodie. We just did a song with DJ Khalid, Nas, Jay-Z, and a couple of other people. Check that out, be up there. And what do you feel about these features right now, Joe?
I'm loving it. I mean, I've said it on this before, I love A Boogie. Big A Boogie guy. I've been listening to Big Sean forever. Since as a graduate, one of his first whatever it was, the mixtapes, they were so good. We ripped on Ross on the Lemon Pepper Freestyle.
A little too hard sometimes.
So I'm excited to see what Ross brings to the table. Diddy, come on. I have no idea what to expect out of Diddy. With this group, with this lineup, it's such a weird, like...
I'm here to see what Diddy brings to a beat in 2021.
I'm here for just this combination of people is just crazy to me, like.
And that's the magic of DJ Khaled.
We just ripped him a little bit on the last video. That is his only upside, is that he does get these people together on music.
Unbelievable.
It is crazy.
Ready to get going? All
right, let's do it.
DJ. 5 minutes. This one's gonna be a little bit longer.
Yeah, DJ Khaled. Right in our face.
Right on key.
The three lines. His three lines. Says it, man, you know. This is my year. I like good girls and Louis Vuitton gear. I like bad bitches, extended long hair. And she like Rap Simmons. My bitch bag like 40K, now she act different. And her ass different. Look, my cash different. I'm getting money on purpose, you got it by accident. Black on black, big bodies, all back to back with it. Popping purse like 3 times a week. Hanging with my savages, yeah. And yeah, I pull up. Put me up right out. Just to do donuts on guard, they don't want smoke with us. They just might fold up. They never noticed us. I had to show up. Look, that double lie with us. You know the stars with us. Heard it on Demon Time. We got a lot with us. All that dangerous, yeah. Do not play with us, yeah. They can't bang with us. They labeled us murderers. I hang with the worst of them. When I bust, you just move. You feisty, baby, but that's how I like you, baby. Maybe like me. I'm rich, don't know if she really like me, yeah. Weird.
Is it like a rule that if A Boogie's on a song, they have to have na 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 na?
Yes.
That's a rule, right?
It is a written, unwritten rule.
It's a written, unwritten rule.
It's not written down, it should be.
We shoot off the hip on this channel. That was choppy as hell.
Yeah, no, that was weird. I don't know if it's the beat. I don't know if it's the YouTube video we're watching. I hope this is the real song because we have not listened to it before. So, but the beat sounds like weird.
Yeah, I agree. It definitely, with the lyrics, the beat definitely sounds super choppy. The lyrics sounded offbeat, a little bit. I'm not trying to violate, it's not like Blueface, but it didn't sound. With the thing with A Boogie, like when he's usually on beat, like his beats are so tailored to his sound.
Yeah, like they hit it the right time.
Yeah,
like,
so
he's an artist, you know.
Right,
it's like the.
Like, it would be weird to see him on a beat. Like, it's weird to see him on a feature, just like it would be weird if NF was on a feature, because their beats are so... They live in a world of just their beats.
Yeah.
So...
Makes sense.
It was kind of... That's why
And he just switched up the flow here, and this was weird.
Yeah, it's a little choppy. It's just, to me, right now.
I thought they were about to switch when the guy... Like, there's some background noise, people talking, whatever it is. I thought they were about to switch and just start going back and forth. That would have been cool.
Yeah, I'm always here for the back and forth. Like RNP with Cordae and Anderson Paak.
This is literally the song I'm thinking of too.
That is for me the epitome of back and forth.
But like, yeah, like
even Cordae, Young Thug we had today was pretty good.
Yeah, they go back and forth with each other a little bit. It just you know, it's like they're interacting, like they're actually in the booth together. It sounds like, you know?
And you can see them on stage always being back to back, you know.
Yeah, I mean that's the cool part about actually seeing like a rock band live. Like they're all on stage doing it together. They have to time it like. Yeah. Making a rap song when you finish your verse, the next guy goes like, "That's great," but it's like, we have to work together, make this sound good.
Yeah, I mean it's cool. It adds an artistic and a little bit more art to it.
Exactly. B's and M's is what I came to touch. She woke me up the head and made me blush. Damn. Dodging all the shots that aimed at us. Something dangerous. Losing team ain't no way that's us. Mama went to jobs that worked for half her life. She turned it down and I was the reply. It's the
like, yo, man, how's it going?
Oh, all right, Big Sean.
So like, this is more of a Big Sean beat. It's a rap. He can rap. Like, he just rap. Not that A Boogie can't rap.
I can't.
But
not like Big Sean. Not like Big Sean can. You can't just give him a mic and let him spit bars. He's all about the melody, A Boogie, and he kills it. Bro. He's great at what he does. Two lines I love so far: "Mama prayed to God, and I was the reply." Sick.
That is sick.
And I'm my only enemy, so if we don't win, it's self-sabotage. I like that. That's cool.
Yeah, and it's a good way to, I mean, just to look at it. Like, if I don't succeed, it's on me.
It's on me. There's no excuses. Else.
Yeah.
Which is a cool way to live. Not a lot of people live that way. So that's it. I'm in control, all in my cut, even in courtrooms. You chasing the hoes that chase money, that chase me. While I'm growing up with blueprints in the motherfucking courtroom. And she knows no strings attached, and we found private there and back. And her base private, not like that. Brightest energy, my soul seems CC White is on the track. Me and Khaled, we go back, but we ain't never going back. Don't get good friends. But you just
know. Oh, that's the chorus. But that's how I like you,
baby. Not a fan of it.
Yeah, I'm not a fan of the chorus. This is my year. Odd.
That's a rough song. It's a rough bar just to come in on. Straight drop dead lead bias. You know who lead bias is, Joe? He's the number one NBA draft player, I think, in 1980, I believe. He got drafted to the Celtics, and he died on draft night.
All right, I know the story. I didn't know the name. Okay, that's, yeah.
He just jumps in, straight drop dead, Len Bias. Sheesh.
All right.
My trap spot, straight fire. All right.
Those weren't correspond, but my trap spot, straight fire. Running through the course, made it playing like a sport. Set the streets on fire, left it burning like a torch. All I want is two those gave the charges to the boys. Now I'm bigger than the blogs, not a topic on the Forbes. Catch a fair charge, now we pardoned by the laws. Niggas better stay in line, I want to sit them in the mall. Heaven now on earth, half a million on the watch. Three bands on the sweater, just to let a nigga
watch. For him. Right?
Yeah. No trumpet. Double M on the lock. 305 the code. If you want to get a block, you can send it Bitcoin time to triple little stock. Bitcoin's a hot topic on his album. Bitcoin's a hot topic on this album. Nas talked about it as well.
Yeah, 100%. Bitcoin, Coinbase, all these guys.
Making money. That's the new money.
305 the code. If you want to get a block. You can send in Bitcoin. It's time to triple with stocks. Yeah, what's up with this? All eyes on me. You guys are living in a box. That like a shot?
Well, got the haters leaving comments while I'm really sending shots. Like, you're living in a box. Like a box.
Okay. Cause.
Like, you're not living real life, and you're living your life on this because, like, on the internet, like, you know, you post something, and then it's like. You get bombarded with something, and it seems like
so
all
you don't
eyes
think
on me.
That has anything.
I see what you're saying. Like the only reason I say no is just because.
I don't know why.
No. I take it back. I take that back. No. All eyes on me, and I'm really sending shots. Like you know, like
fair.
That. You know, it is. That is. Like, it's a double. It's a double.
Granted, like it's a good like it's a phrase people use. But it's also like
he said that he literally says that in Lemon Pepper Freestyle. It's the only line I remember. He goes, "Yeah, all eyes on me." Says it like that. Like I mean, it's four words, whatever.
Yeah, that's fair.
But like that's I don't know if that's his thing. No, I'm just saying I don't know if that's his thing. You know, maybe.
No, that's fair. You're
maybe
right.
That's his 2021 view.
You know, we be fishing sometimes. Okay,
here comes Dave.
I'm excited for this.
Is he not rap? Black motherfucking rich shit. Ownership shit. Godly shit. Yeah. As we proceed, give you what you need. Come back in the day. We wasn't talking shit. What the fuck you done? We here. Y'all motherfuckers acting like y'all got amnesia or something. The truth will set you free. The truth album? Did he not rap and he's featured for yelling for 30 seconds?
That's OD.
What? What was that?
He was just yelling about how things was, he did 30 years ago.
Was that, and was that shots about like him saying like he's here now, we're here now? Or is that like about society, like what's going on now? Like,
yeah,
I don't know what
the I don't know. He didn't clarify. He just was yelling. I mean,
is he bringing up shots about Interscope and all that old stuff? Like
when he, I see. So what I was gonna say is when he said like I put this thing together, I think he means rap. Rap.
All right, relax. I would say he's the one who commercialized it and made it what now people, some people don't like about it.
Okay, I mean he gave the world Biggie Smalls.
All right, but he like, also you know, like, he also well, we talked a little bit about with Eminem like. The was the Interscope magazine, right?
What, the one that he went to war with? Source?
The source. There you go. I was looking for the name of it.
Yeah.
Right? That was the source for music. Like, everyone went there. And that's why Eminem started beefing with him. Because instead of putting people that were actually good at music, he was putting people he wanted to promote.
Yeah, he was getting paid to promote.
Yeah. So it's like...
No, I get that. But, I mean, without P. Diddy, there's no money in hip-hop.
I hear what you're saying, but this is literally what just happened with that Super League with soccer. People were like, we're monetizing it. Hey, why are you making it monetized?
That's a good reference, bro.
But like, that's what I'm saying, though. And that's what, but that's what real rappers, like Marlon Craft, I'm not in this for the money.
Yeah, that's fair.
I'm doing this for the music, yeah, for the artistic
his,
value.
His freestyle, that you're worried about the income, I'm worried about the outcome.
Yeah, exactly. Which obviously these guys need to make a living.
Yeah.
But, and again, to the other song with the Jordan Lucas song, like when he's like, you put me in these chains. And it goes from him signing, it looks like he's going to jail, and then it's him signing a record deal.
Yeah.
Like, you know, like, and was P. Diddy, I'm not saying, I don't know all the history behind everything, but was P. You know, P. Diddy was one of those guys that pushed for guys to, you know, sign here, you'll make money. Because in the end, the music industry will make the money.
It's also crazy, though, that that's what he was on the song to do.
That was a weird. Like, why was DJ Khaled, this was a good idea, you know? Let's add him in there. It was actually, Rick Ross and Big Sean were in bed. A Boogie Let Me Down. Yeah, that was rough. And I mean, the chorus, at least I'll take, it wasn't as bad as I originally thought. I thought the chorus was just part of his rap.
Yeah.
The chorus is...
not good.
Dog shit. Just to put it lightly. And this is my year. I mean, I'm sure at the end of the song, DJ Khaled will yell, this is my year, or one of them will.
Yeah, like, what is this even...
But
like,
what does that have to... Like,
the chorus
I just,
has nothing to do with
this.
That.
The whole chorus is about... getting women because I'm rich, pretty much.
Like, literally, the only person who brought up years was P. Diddy, and he was yelling. Not even rapping. He said, well, you've been doing this for 30 years.
Weird. Let's see. I don't know. Let's play it out the rest of the minute and see if I like you, baby. Like a maybe like me. I'm rich, don't know. Could just be wrong. Like hopefully, me. He just raps.
Yeah, maybe he gets it wrong right now. When I bust, you just move. You feisty, baby, but that's how I like you, baby. Like a maybe like me. I'm rich, don't know. She really like me, yeah. I like the when I bust you just move has the flow of like the I will not lose.
Yes.
Like the old J.
That's what I was thinking and that's what it was sounding like. I couldn't put my thumb on it either. But
it doesn't go with the beat.
I'm gonna double back on what I just said about how bad this chorus is. If this was just an A Boogie song with him singing this chorus to his beat.
Yeah, it's a beat that goes with it, yeah.
Like, it would not be terrible. Like, what you just said, like, it doesn't sound horrible if it's just him. Like, yeah. This beat's a little relaxed now at the end of the song.
That's why I go back to what I said at the beginning. A Boogie is great on beats that are built for A Boogie.
Absolutely.
And, I mean, not every rapper has to have crazy range. Maybe it stuns him later on, but he has a fan base that loves what he does.
Yeah.
And it's adaptable to a point. But you just can't throw him on a beat with everything, you know?
Yeah, with every rapper.
Plus, this beat is kind of, like, wanky.
Yeah. Oh, that was it.
What happens with the next?
That's one of those again. That was weird.
Yeah, that was really weird. I think Big Sean had the best verse.
100%.
I think it goes Sean Ross... A Boogie because he had one and P. Diddy, and I think the
I mean, actually, the I think gap. I want to fix you that list right there. I think it goes Big Sean, Rick Ross, A Boogie, DJ Khaled yelling his name in the beginning.
Yeah,
and
no,
then Diddy. Because that was DJ dumb Khaled. As hell. And I shit on DJ Khaled for what he does in the beginning of the songs.
Yeah, I agree, honestly.
But at least it's tasteful, you know it's coming. Like, you know, exactly.
like it's on beat, sort of.
Like, we literally, the beginning of this video was we were hyped to see Diddy rap in 2021. Yeah. And it just left such a shitty taste in my mouth.
I'm hella disappointed.
Yeah, like that just, that, I mean. Come on. And then to go back what we were saying on the last video.
Check that out.
With the Jay-Z and Nas song. About how DJ Khaled puts together playlists. This is the song right before that Nas and Jay-Z song. Like, if this was played back to back, like, they're not, like, there's not that there should be a correlation with every song, but, like, there's no, like, how would I transition from this into the first, like, couple lyrics from Nas? Like, I only stand next to gods when it's Diddy's yelling on a beat, A Boogie sounds out of place, Rick Ross is doing classic Rick Ross things, and then Big Sean actually shows up a little bit.
Yeah, people are gonna think our channel hates Rick Ross.
I love Rick Ross. I do love Rick Ross. Yeah, I love Rick Ross, I'm just saying, but it's the same thing for the past 15 years. Like, yeah, he gets on the beat, he raps, he literally said the same, like, some of the same lines.
Yeah,
like,
all eyes on me.
But it sounds good, you know what you're gonna get? It's big, you know, Rick Ross, big boss shit, as he would say.
What did I give the last time? 6.7? I'm giving this a 6.4.
I was going lower. I was gonna say.
Alright. No, I'm gonna stick at a 6.4. That's the lowest I'm gonna go for this.
I'll give it a 6.0, and I was tempted to even go a tiny bit lower. 5.8.
That would be like if I had to give a spectrum, I'd say it could be a 5.8. I'm gonna go 6.4.
I take that back. You know what? It's a 5.7.
Yeah, 5.7.
Because I will never listen to this again.
Never once.
For the strict, like, I love A Boogie. It was disappointing. I don't want to read that.
I'm gonna give it 5.8.
And Diddy ruined the song. Like, after Rick Ross, like, you have to shut this song off, or you'll literally be like, what is going on? And there's no music video, which, at least if there was, explain why he's yelling and give us some background.
Yeah, I also want to know why the title is This Is My Year.
Does that have to do with him yelling? Like, I don't know. Is he planning something this year? But again, this is not a Diddy album. I don't know. Does Diddy produce DJ?
I don't know what Diddy even does anymore.
But is he related to DJ Khaled's production? I don't think so.
DJ Khaled.
Why would DJ Khaled want him yelling that on his song?
No idea. Just so people could see Diddy and click on it like we did.
Like, son of a bitch.
They got us. I'm changing mine to 5.8. You're going 5.7. This is not a great one, but let us know what you guys think in the comments. Let us know a song from DJ Khaled you guys like, or just another song we should do. Like, comment, subscribe, and we'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace. Check out our Instagram. It's TheMove_. Have a good one.
Peace.
Peace. It's The Move.